Hey guys, John Carey, 1963 Jag, down under the Jag today. As I mentioned, I took the wheel off on the passenger rear side and was working on tightening up things and just double checking everything under here. And while I was down here, I decided I'd just sort of nut and bolt all the bolts on the rear suspension. And what I found was quite a few of these bolts that are holding the plate on the bottom of the IRS cage assembly, I hadn't cranked down all the way. The ones that were going up into the rear suspension fulcrum blocks, I had tightened, but these ones that are just clamping the flange of the IRS cage itself to this little bottom plate here along the outside edge, one, two, three, on both sides were not completely tightened up, so I cranked those up good. And then while I was in here inspecting, one of the surprises that I came across was I was putting the emergency brake cable and all that jazzmatazz on, and then I looked up and saw that there were only two bolts through the pinion flange into the drive shaft out of four. So I was able to put those in there, which was a good find, a good catch. I was happy about that. And then I snugged up, everything I could. This drain plug on the bottom of my differential was weeping a little bit, so I put a wrench on that and gave it about a 16th of a turn. And I think my rear plate cover gasket has, you know, sort of given me fits since I first put the oil in the diff. It's been leaking. I tightened it up. I really can't tighten that anymore, and the way it's mounted up in here, if you can get back a little bit, I'll show you that there's this, you know, the shock absorbers are in the way, the brake discs are in the way, the cage is in the way. There's just no way to get at the back of the pumpkin. I put a wrench on the bottom three nuts, and they were as tight as I could do. Couldn't budge them by hand, so it is what it is, I guess. You know, I'm just going to have to live with it. So, but anyway, here's a little, you know, tour of the bottom of the car. So things are looking good. I loosened up my anti-sway bar link nuts and bushing bolts because I've been warned that if those are tight when you crank them down while you're on the cars in the air and then you set them down, you're going to be twisting the bushings, and that's not good for them. You want to make sure that they're in the relaxed position when you finally put it all together, or when you finally crank them up tight. So that's what I did, and then I'm just going to scoot out. Sorry for the shaky cam. The wheel service specialist that I took them to true them up, the spokes, and then mount the wheels and the tires. These are tubed tires on this car, so I have tubes in there. He gave me some acid-based wheel wash, which is sort of a purplish color, and it has a real pleasant, almost sweet smell to it, but I was a little afraid of it because he wrote on the outside of the bottle acid based, you know, so it kind of spooked me out. So I put rubber gloves on and stuff, but I was worried about getting it on the rubber and all that. So if anybody knows, you know, what that might be, would you let me know? Because I don't quite know how to use it, and it's not in an original container, it's just in a bottle he gave me. But I think these wheels came pretty clean. A little hard to see because of all the glare, sorry. But you see this flat hub in here. This is the Series 2 Jag E-Type wheel, which has this smooth hub finish here. The original Series 1 cars had like a little scoop-de-doop in there. They call them curly hubs down inside, and they were a bear to get clean. So these were designed to be easy clean, and the previous owner, James, bought these Series 2 wheels, even though I have a Series 1 car, so I'm a little, you know, not conflicted so much as just, it's one of the many things I've done to this car that are not original for the Series 1. So there's the other one on the other side, and I think I even got this one a little cleaner than the other one, so this is really in great shape. I mean, it's looking great. And I even took a little wadding polish to the lead weights that the guy put on the outside of the wheel, because I guess the wheel took an awful lot of weight to get in balance. In this case, he's got weights on the back and on the front. And there's a big one here on the front. So that wheel must have been pretty far out. And here's what they look like before I've serviced them. So, you know, that's kind of the finish of that. There's some like dust and grease and goo and grime on them. So here's one that wasn't cleaned yet. So that's kind of the way they look before the super polish. So I think it's going to turn out real nice, and everything's going good. So, so far so good, tightening things up, getting things locked down. When I was up in this wheel well, I noticed that my, again, the previous owner had drilled holes in the bodywork here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and over here, 1, 2, 3. So I was able to fit some plastic body plugs in here. So I plugged those up. There were some little sheet metal screw holes, which I put some caulking on, and I sealed these over with some butyl-based caulking. And then where the rivets and screws punctured the bodywork for the rear interior, I also put a little caulking over those so that they wouldn't weep and get liquids and waters and stuff that soak through where the screw holes were and into the interior carpet and trim work. And here's a little shot of my remote rear brake bleeders. You know, the brakes on the E-Type in the back are all the way up inside the suspension, so the brake rotors are up right next to the pumpkin, and to get to the calipers is one hellacious project to get your hand up in there to bleed. So I put some little extension pipes on and put them on little clamps down here where I can get at them, take this wheel off, and I can get both sides bled in a heartbeat. And some other stuff I did, which I hadn't done yet, I safety wired my what they call the fulcrum. No, what do they call these? Radius arms. So this arm stabilizes the rear suspension forward and back, and there's a safety strap on that so that that arm won't, you know, pop out. So I lock wired that in the way it was originally. And then I was kind of looking around down here on the floor, and I see there's a lot of holes, and I'm not quite sure, you know, what's going on there. Water drain hole. I'm really not. Hey guys, John Kerry, 1963 Jag, coming at you with an update after the glory of my first drive to go get some gas. We realized we had a little problem. Once the fuel tank was full, it was leaking like a sieve here from the submersible fuel pumps fitting where the electrical wiring goes down into the fuel pump. I had leaks around the gasket as well, but that was able to tighten up. But this particular leak here just keeps seeping and seeping and seeping, and eventually I think what's happened is the fuel got down into the reservoir or the space where the wire goes, and the pump has stopped working. So it's either shorted out or burned out or both. I don't know which. So I have no fuel pump, so I can't start the car anymore, and the tank is over full, probably, because I released this banjo fitting, and it was, like, squirting out, so, you know, I filled the damn tanks, thinking that was the right thing to do, but, you know, it's on a slope going downhill in this direction, and that's, you know, underneath the liquid level. So I'm going to have to go get a pump, like a little drill motor pump or something, to kind of get some of the fuel out of here, so that I can pull that cover tank plate off the tank and replace the fuel pump. Which is pretty depressing, but it is what it is. I also was doing a little adjustment to the carburetor this afternoon. Not the carburetor, but the choke linkages to the bottom of the carburetor. And while I was over here, I happened to look down on the ground because I dropped a bolt or a washer or something, and guess what I found? A puddle, and that's right near where the water pump is. So I don't know where that leak is coming from. It's up in this area of the motor somewhere, so I'm gonna have to hunt for that tomorrow. These are the kinds of things I guess you just have to troubleshoot. So little by little I'm gonna work my way down the list and get to each one of them, but for the moment the leaking fuel tank is a bit of a problem because it smells like fuel in my garage, and I'm a little nervous about closing it up overnight and letting it just seep away and leak. I came out this morning and the top of the tank was completely wet, covered in fuel that had seeped out, and it ran down into the gaps, and just not good for a lot of reasons. So I'm not quite sure. I can't do much about it tonight because I don't have the right tools to pump the tank, but I'm going to have to drain the tank down to a point where I can at least get a couple of gallons out of here, put it in my plastic fuel tank, and then I'll have to order a new fuel pump. I'm hoping they'll replace it for free. It's brand new, you know, it's only run for, I don't know, maybe a total of about a half an hour. So, yeah, not thrilled about that. But everything else is coming along okay. I'm just piddling around with stuff. I was working on my my choke lever handle today, which didn't quite, the new one didn't look right. So I took my old one and I polished it, and then I sprayed some enamel down into the writing here. I've masked that off real good. So the only place that white paint is going to be right around the lettering, and I think I can take some polishing compound and sort of, you know, just clean off the surface, and I'll get a really nice, you know, lettering down inside the silk, or down inside the engraving. The new one just didn't fit right, and I've got a mail call to do. I got a sticker from Hair BMW. Thank you. And I sent one off to you today, so hopefully that'll come in a couple days. And been watching a few videos from a few guys. You know, Greg, obviously getting ready for the Greaserama, so I know he's busy and going like crazy. Chef Tush got a lot done when he was on holiday, but now he's back at work, so not too much happening. Ruben, you know, making great progress, kicking along. Dan Electro, Neil, haven't heard from you in a long time. I wrote you a note. Thanks for the compliment and the comments on my channel. I wonder what you're up to. Give us an update, even if it's nothing. Tell us what's going on. Cecil's making good progress cleaning things up. I liked his little saying, it's Mustang time in Tennessee. Mustang time in Tennessee. I can't say it right, can I, Cecil? What else? Haven't heard a thing from Ed the Kid lately. Cheater 40, keeping busy, watching my stuff. Thank you. It's great to see you. Ron, Wrecking Yard, where's that Porsche, man? Come on. Rick the Fix, doing great. The Nova looks fabulous. We're not even calling it Franken Nova anymore. Doing a great job. It looks great. And, what else? Joe, saw a little bit on your Mustang, Rudder's Garage. Joe, Rudder Iffy. And, Milrick put a few videos up a little while ago. Matt is working on Rusty and the 57 Chevy, and a lot of good stuff going on. What else? In Debt for Kids. I think your name is Steve, isn't it? I hope it is. We haven't seen much from you lately. I guess you've been working a lot. Mark at Second Gen Garage. I don't know what's going on with you, buddy. Matt at Buck's Wood Shop. I know you've been working. John, paving the driveway, I guess, but not doing much with the Mustang, are you? Tom, I'm watching you all the time, you know, kind of checking out what you're up to. Saw Doug's thing for his brother, Bob. That was a very nice tribute. All those Model Ts were cooler than can be. BW Darren, yeah, I've seen you in a little while. But, you put up a couple of vids. You were working on that 1600. And Zig, thanks for the compliments on my car. Adam, I don't think Adam's been doing much lately, has he? Haven't heard from you. Got that new house, I guess, so you were kind of busy. Bridge shift truck. Rich, Satajet, 883. Not much from you guys. At least I haven't seen much. Steve's Garage, I saw a couple of videos from you. Yeah, saw you, Steve. That was cool. I saw your ice water challenge. That was good. So anyway, I hope everybody's going to have a good time. Oh, yeah. Cutworm and... Shade Tree Fix-It Man, definitely, appreciate it. There's Bettie riding the rocket. She's a cutie pie, as is Jackie. Jackie's a cutie pie too. All right, guys, have a good one, and remember, it's Jaguar parking only. See you later.